steps its flow may richer fuller be. O love that will not let me go, O joy that seekest me through pain, I cannot close my heart to thee. I trace the rainbow through the rain and feel the promise is not vain, that morn shall tearless be. O love that will not let of my head, I dare not ask to fly from thee. I lay in dust life's glory dead, and from the ground there blossoms life that shall end less. Be, O love that will not let me go, O love that will not let me
privilege to welcome each of you to this memorial service for Jerry Richmond Terry. Your presence here this afternoon shows your love for this family and for the influence of Jerry in your lives. I know that his family appreciates the prayers and the support and the encouragement that you have given to them. And your presence here is a gift. During this service, Frank Thomas will minister in song. Kathy May will share a poem. Jerry's brother, John, will give some reflections from the family. And my name is Steve Potts, and it is my privilege to serve as pastor of Westwood Baptist Church, and I will share a brief message from God's Word. A time like this is a time of grief, and it is a time of peace. The grief is appropriate because the person who we are here to remember is deeply missed, and his life made a big difference in his family and among his friends. The grief is right because you miss him, and that is a reflection of your love. But we are also glad today that it is a time of peace, because Jerry had faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. He is not gone, he is home. He is absent from us, but he is present with the Lord. And so we seek the Lord's peace and mercy even in this time of sorrow. Because Jesus has conquered death, we have hope, even in a time like this. The Bible tells us in Psalm 46 that God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. The Lord is here. He is with you. He wants to sustain you and to help you. Jesus said to his disciples in John chapter 11, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. We rejoice today that Jesus conquered death, and he shares that victory with all who trust in him. The Apostle Paul experienced that in a personal way in his life. And he realized that when we receive the love of Christ, it is a love that will not let me go, just as the song just sang. Romans 8 tells us in verse 38, I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The love of God did not let Jerry down. The love of God brought Jerry home to heaven. And we rejoice in that today. Would you join me in prayer? Heavenly Father, we come before you today. Our hearts are heavy because Jerry is not with us. But our hearts are lightened because he is with you. We ask, Lord, that you would bring your peace and mercy to his family and these gathered friends. We thank you for the privilege of knowing Jerry Terry and for the gift of his life. We ask for your comfort to overflow to these who loved him so deeply and miss him so much. We thank you for the peace that you bring to all who trust in you. And we thank you that your Son, Jesus Christ, is the Savior of the world. He is our hope because he has conquered death. And one day there will be a great reunion of all those who have trusted in him. It is in hope of that that we gather together today, thanking you and seeking your presence and your mercy. We ask all of this in the powerful and glorious name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
He went to sleep one night, never here to awake again. But everything was all right between him and God. So he awoke in heaven's courtyard, free from pain within. The angels gathered round him, and they took him by the hand. Serenaded by angels up to the throne. Serenaded by angels finally at home. Surrounded by praises to the King. Welcome to heaven, the angels did sing. Now when I close my eyes at night, and I try to imagine that city of brilliant light waiting for me. But my mind cannot conceive, so I'll continue to grieve till I'm transported there, and then I shall be serenaded by angels up to the throne. Serenaded by angels finally at home. Surrounded by praises to the King. Welcome to paradise. Welcome to heaven. The angels still sing.
Bone of My Bones, written by Kathy May. How can I learn to live without you when my every day for 51 years has been connected to you? We are one flesh. We are connected at the heart. How can I learn to live without you when for 51 years we've had our ups and downs, happiness and sorrows, walking through valleys and standing on mountains together? How can I learn to live without you when for 51 years we walked through each day face to face and side by side? We built our life together. We brought our children home together. We held each other tight in hard times, and we laughed through all the good. How can I learn to live without you? I can learn to live without you because I am not really without you. You are living in another place, standing with a great cloud of witnesses, walking the streets of gold, and talking with Jesus. I love you to the moon and back, my love, until we meet again in heaven. Genesis 2:24, and the man said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh."
Rusty Goodman wrote a song several years ago that expresses some thoughts of mine about heaven. When you finally make your entrance to that city of jasper walls and bright golden avenues, as you behold all its beauty and its splendor, remember there's just one request I make of you. Look for me, for I will be there too. I realize when you arrive, there'll be so much to view. And after you've been there 10,000 years, 1,000,000 maybe too, look for me, for I will be there too. As you go down your list of first, there's no question, you'll want to see your many loved ones waiting there for you. And when you finally told your story to the last one that wants to hear just how you made the journey through, look for me, for I will be there too. I realize when you arrive, there'll be so much to view. And after you've been there 10,000 years, 1,000,000, maybe two, look for me, for I will be there too. Yes, look for me, for I will be there too.
Along with Steve, and on behalf of our family, we thank you so much for being here this day to show your love. In the past few months, Jerry hated goodbyes, and he would correct me so many times and tell me, "Don't tell me goodbye. Tell me, see me later." And he corrected me so many times. But last Tuesday, we sat with most of his family at his bed, told him goodbye. And many months ago, the reason that I'm not on the list is Jerry made me promise I wouldn't say anything to Martha or any of the family. But he asked me, would I say something for him to Martha? And I said, "Here it. I don't know what to say." He said, "But at that time, you'll know." So I wrote this to Martha from Jerry. And if he was here himself, I think he would say this to Martha. And I would like to read it. "Do not weep" is how I entitled it. "When you remember me, please do not weep. My body may not be there. It has chosen to sleep. I'm not that far away. My soul will live on, looking down, watching over you and everyone. And when you feel sad and life seems so blue, just remember that my spirit has its arms wrapped around you. And on those special days, times that you wish I could see, that cool breeze blowing past you, well, that'll be me. So please don't be sad. I hope you have no fear. I'm not that far away. I will always be here. I will still watch over you every minute of every day. My love is always with you, and that's where it will stay. Today I feel no pain. My body is no longer weak. Nothing but peaceful rest. So for me, please do not weep.
Jerry Terry was a cherished husband, father, and grandfather, a treasured brother and uncle, and an honored friend to many. But above all that, he was a child of God who trusted Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. When he died last Tuesday, he left behind a great void in your heart, a void that only the Lord can fill. He knows how to help even at a time when sorrow can seem overwhelming. The Lord can be trusted because he cares for us. He cares for all his people. In the Bible, King David reflected on his life, and he thought about how God had watched over him and reminded him of when he was a boy watching over the flocks out on the fields. And he wrote this beloved psalm, Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff. They comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. As David thought about God's faithfulness to him, he wanted to share to God's people that they could trust the Lord as their shepherd as well. And as we think about Jerry's life, I want to draw three quick lessons from that psalm. The first is this: the Lord leads us through life. We thank the Lord for Jerry's earthly life because God was with him. He gave Jerry life and breath, just as he gives life and breath to all of us. We owe everything we are and have to God. And yet, because of sin, we need him as our Savior. We have been separated from him. And he watches over us and he leads us to those paths of righteousness that we might find our way to him. But as we think about Jerry's life, we realize that God was with him each step of the way. He watched over as Jerry was born on June 7, 1944, here in Birmingham. His parents were Glenn and Merlee Terry, and he has two brothers and two sisters. One of the brothers is not able to be with us today, but he is here in prayer, no doubt. Jerry graduated from Minor High School. If you've been watching any of the pictures, you know that. In the graduating class of 1962. He then went to work for Bowman Transportation, where he started at the loading docks and eventually made local truck deliveries. After that, he joined the insurance business, working with Mutual Savings, Independent Life, and finally American General. He retired from insurance in 1997, and then he opened a convenience store called Jerry's Groceries, which he operated until about 2005. Many of you here today probably met Jerry along that journey at some point, whether in school or working with him in the insurance business, perhaps visiting Jerry's Groceries, perhaps you met him at church. But once you met him, you knew who he was and that he was a person worth knowing. Now, Jerry and Martha went to the same high school together, but they really didn't know each other. Although that's not quite true, Martha tells me she knew who he was because she would hear over the PA system, "Jerry Terry, please report to the principal's office." She assumed the principal needed some guidance and counsel because frequently Jerry got to go and meet with the principal. But she didn't really get to know Jerry until one day she and some friends went to Woody's Tasty Treat to get some hamburgers. And there was Jerry. And Jerry struck up a conversation, and somewhere in that conversation, he managed to finagle a phone number from Miss Martha, which he did not let go to waste. He called her, they dated, and that was in 1965, and they were married later that same year. And they were married for 51 years. They became the parents of Michelle, who was dearly loved. She passed away a few years ago. Their parents of Bart, and the parents of Joey. And Joey came into their life in a unique way, and he wrote some words about that experience. He said, "Everyone who knew Jerry Terry already knows how great a man we have lost. He was the most generous, selfless, and giving person you will ever come across. At a very young age, I was introduced to Pawpaw, and little did I know at the time he would become my father. How lucky was I that Mr. Terry chose to love me unconditionally as a son and to adopt me as he was retiring. To take such responsibility is a true testament to his character and love. I will never forget the memories we shared and the life lessons he taught me. It is hard to imagine life without you, Pawpaw. But I know you will be up above watching every Alabama game with me. I love you all the way to the moon and back, Joey." And I believe that each part of their family would share similar love and devotion and appreciation, even though in life, relationships are far from perfect. There are ups, there are downs, there are stresses, and there are strife. But underneath it all, there can be love. And that is certainly true. Jerry loved his whole family, including his grandchildren, Dusty and Kaylee, who are very precious to him, as well as all the nieces and nephews, and too many family members for me to mention at this time. This is a family that got together. They went to reunions in Florida, Destin and then Fort Walton, often getting together. And there was a very important part of Jerry's life that showed up in Florida, but not just in Florida, and that was golf. Involved hitting a little white ball with a stick. And Jerry was very good at that. He learned from his parents and his father and his uncles. And he, as long as his health would allow, participated in that as often as he could. He and Martha had the opportunity to travel a good bit, especially when he was working in the insurance industry. They traveled to Hawaii and to Dallas and San Francisco and Boston, just to name a few places. And Jerry grew up in the Church of Christ and later started attending Westwood when he married Martha. He didn't come as regularly as Miss Martha would like at first. But one time he was in the hospital, and Martha's Sunday school teacher, a precious lady by the name of Willie Benson, had been praying for Jerry. And she was on the case. And she went to the hospital, and she reminded Jerry of what he had known since as a child, that we have to trust Jesus Christ. to be a Savior and the Lord of our life. And Jerry looked over to her and said, I'm ready. And she prayed with Jerry. And Jerry was. And after that, soon he was baptized. He was a regular part of the church family for as long as his health would allow. He was always there. In 2013, his health declined significantly, and he faced many physical challenges. Sometimes he got a little better. Sometimes he got a little worse. But since January, he was privileged to stay at the Cherry Hill Rehab, and he was there with Martha faithfully with him. And it was from there that he traveled to the hospital and then took the ultimate journey to heaven last Tuesday. But at each step of the way, whether it was going to the principal's office, whether it was that happenstance meeting at the Tasty Treat, whether it was swinging the golf club, whether it was family time, whether it was in church, whether it was watching the Alabama game, whether it was working alongside friends, the Lord was walking with Jerry each step of the way. He leads us through life, through the mountain peaks and in the valleys. The second lesson is that he protects us in death, because there's a valley that we will pass through, as Jerry has. And the Bible describes it in Psalm 23 as the valley of the shadow of death. Now, there are times when darkness and difficulty we experience in life. And sometimes it's not our illness, but that of loved ones, as when you went through the sorrow of saying goodbye to your daughter. Jerry was there in that valley, and he knew what it was to lean on the Lord. But when we encounter death ourselves, we do not fear. We need not fear, for the Lord is with us. Our bodies may wear out, but our faith doesn't. Our Savior doesn't. He is with us, therefore we need not fear. Someone has said that when we are born, we are crying, and everyone around us is happy. But if we know the Lord, when we die, everyone around us may be crying, but we are eternally happy. And so today we rejoice that the Lord was with Jerry and brought him safely to his heavenly kingdom. And the reason we face death is because the Bible tells us sin entered into the relationship between God and man. The Bible says in Romans 6:23 that the wage of sin is death. And yet, the good news is, the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Because of Jesus, we have a hope that is stronger than death. There was a preacher in Philadelphia many years ago by the name of Donald Barnhouse. His wife passed away, and coming home from the funeral in a car with his little girls, they stopped at a stoplight. And while they were at the stoplight, a large truck pulled up next to them, and the car was engulfed in the shadow of that truck. Pastor Barnhouse looked at his little girls, and he asked them this question. He said, which would you rather be hit by, the shadow of that truck or that truck? The little girls thought, he said, well, the shadow, Daddy. He said, that's right. The Bible tells us that we are in the valley of the shadow of death. But because Jesus took death himself, the only thing we will experience, the only thing Mama experienced, was the shadow of death. For Jesus has rescued his people. And we're here today to celebrate the fact that Jerry Carey is not simply passed away. He is delivered from this life, and he's brought into eternal life because Jesus took our eternal death for us so that all who trust in him will receive eternal life. And that's the last lesson. Not only does the Lord lead us in life and protect us in death, but he welcomes us to heaven. Now, David says in Psalm 23 that the Lord spreads out a banquet for us in the presence of our enemies. And he's telling us that the Lord brings many blessings into our lives, even when we're still surrounded by creditors and difficulties in this life. But he says, goodness and mercy pursue us, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And what David is saying is God brings many blessings and foretastes of our heavenly joys, but we don't experience the joys until one day we are with the Lord in his house forever. The Lord brings us home. In John 3:16, the Bible says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. We get to heaven not because of our goodness or how well we walk with the Lord. We get to heaven because we trust the Savior and we receive that gift. In the Bible, for the believer, death is shown as not just a departure from this life, but an arrival in our heavenly home. The destination has been settled by Jesus. And heaven is more than a place. It is a presence with the person of our Lord. The thing that makes heaven truly heaven is being with Jesus. We rejoice today because Jerry has completed his earthly walk, and now he's home with the Lord. And the good news is that everyone who trusts in Christ will one day experience the very same thing. The Bible tells us that that's not the whole story, that one day Jesus will come back and there will be a glorious resurrection where we'll be given new bodies. See, when we die, our spirit goes immediately with the Lord and our bodies are resting. But when Jesus returns and the trumpet sounds, the dead are resurrected in Christ. And all who know him will dwell with him forever. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 tells us, the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command and with the voice of an archangel and with the sound of the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will always be with the Lord. Ms. Martha, you and your family have had times of family reunion where you've gotten together and had a great time of fellowship. And even in today's sadness, you've got to talk to many people that you've known for many years. Some perhaps you've not seen for a long time who've come to express to you and your family their love and support. There's a joy in seeing people and being with people that we know and love. But the Bible tells us one day that joy won't be a fleeting moment. It won't be at Destin. It won't be in a funeral home. It'll be unblemished by death and parting. It'll be a reunion that will go on forever in the presence of Jesus. And we will have new bodies that never get sick or grow old or hurt. We will be set free from our sins and temptations. We will be together forever with him. And it is that which we celebrate today. And it is that which we hold on to. And the key to the whole thing, for not just Jerry, but for all of us, is putting our trust in the one who died and rose again, who gives eternal life as a gift, not because we deserve it, but to anyone and everyone who trusts in Jesus Christ. It's in Jesus that you can make it through today and tomorrow and tomorrow. To Jerry's family, to Martha, to Dusty, to Bart, to Joey, to Kaylee, to his brother James, to John and their families, to his sisters Jean and Glenda, to all of your family and all the relatives, and these many gathered friends, to many of the class of 1962 that he helped organize many reunion gatherings, I want to commend to you to trust in the Savior that Jerry relied on, who is able to save any and everyone who relies on him. Let us pray. Well, God our Father, we come to you today. The tears are real and the sorrow is true, and yet that is not the whole story. Because if we trust in you and your Son to be our Savior, this is only a moment, but eternity and joy undiminished is awaiting for each one of us. Lord, I pray that you would bring strength and comfort to this family, that you hold them close and give them the strength they need each day. And Lord, may we be reminded, even in this time of memorial, that each one of us have a destiny with death that we must face, and that we need not face it alone or without hope, but if we trust Christ, we will have the greatest hope in all the universe. We pray these things with gladness because of Jesus, in his glorious name, amen and amen. I want to thank you all for coming. The family appreciates your support, and you are dismissed.
Very nice talking to you.
I was in labor.
Hello.